Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you public IP and private IP. Before we start with this session, let me tell you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first I'll explain you what is the meaning of public IP. After that, I'll explain you what is the meaning of private IP. After that, I'll explain you how public to private and private to public IP translation happens. And that I'll explain you by one practical example. I'll show you in my computer how that public to private and private to public IP translation happens. Right. So let us try to understand first what is the meaning of public IP address. Now, before we see what is the meaning of public and private IP, you should know, see, on internet, communication happens with public IP. On internet, communication happens with public IP. But when it comes to local area network, like I'm having 5 computers in my local area network, so that communication happens with private IP. So on internet, entire communication that happens with public IP. And in small local area network, communication is possible with the use of private IP. Right. Now, let us try to understand first what is the basic meaning of public IP. See, a public IP address is assigned to device directly connected to the internet. So, as if your device is directly connected to internet, then you will be assigned with public IP. So, that will allow you to communicate on other devices which are there on internet. Right. See, public address are unique. Public IP address are unique. And private IP address that may be reused by someone else, right? So public IP addresses are unique and globally routable, meaning they can be accessed from anywhere on the internet. Like if you are there in Canada and you want to communicate in Australia, so that is possible by public IP only. The reason is those are unique, right? Private IP addresses are not unique. Remember this. I'll show you by practical example. See, public IP addresses are provided by internet service providers and are used to identify devices on internet. Public IP addresses are visible to other devices on internet and allowing them to initiate communication with device. For example, if you want to communicate with my website, which is engineeringfunda.co.in, then you will be communicating to that website with the use of public IP only. Right. And when I want to communicate on internet, with respect to my LAN, then first of all, I'll be having private IP and my LAN will be having public IP. So via public IP, I'll be communicating on internet. First, let me explain you what is the meaning of private IP. See, private IP addresses are used within local area network, such as home, office, or to identify communication with the devices which are there within the network, right? So private IP cannot be used for internet communication. Private IPs that we use it for local area network communication. So when communication happens within local area network, at that time we use private IP, right? I'll show you by practical example. Right now consider public IPs are used for internet communication and private IPs are used for local area network communication. Public IPs are unique and private IPs may be reused anywhere. Like, for example, in my LAN, I'm having some private IPs. So those private IPs are also used by some other LANs, right? So here you can say private IP addresses are not directly accessible from the internet. They are typically assigned by the network administrator, and dynamic assignment that happens by DHCP protocol. In my previous video, I have explained how DHCP protocol assigns IPs. Right. So within local area network, DHCP protocol can assign you private IP. Right. So that DHCP protocol, which we have seen in my last video, in which I have explained you how dynamically router can assign private IPs. Right. So see, network administrator that can provide you and reserved for a private network use only. So private IPs are used for private networks only. Right. See, private IP addresses are not unique globally. That can be reused by anyone. many devices can have same private IPs within different network. Like for example, if you talk about one private IP which is there in one LAN, then that cannot be reused in same network. But that private IP can be reused in other local area network, right? See, as this private IP that is there for that given network only, so as long as they don't need to communicate with each other directly over the internet. Like for example, we are not directly communicating over the internet. We are communicating via router, right? That's why private IP conflict that will not happen. How it will not happen, I'll show you that. First of all, you need to understand how many private IPs that is available globally. See here, 10.0.0.0 to 10.255.255.255. See this private IP range that is having mask size of 8 bits. Means you see 2 to the power 24 private IPs are available with this range as per mask size, that is /8. Means in total 32 bits are there, 8 bits are masked. So 24 bits are available for this range. 24 bits of IPs means 2 to the power 24 number of IPs are available with this range. That can be used by huge network like Google, Amazon, right? See, second range is there from 172.16.0.0 to 172.31.255.255. Here you see mask size that is of 12 bit, right? So here, see, we are having this range, right? And as per mask, you can calculate how many IPs are available. And usually you'll be observing, see, this is the range which we use in most of the cases, right? You'll be observing this is the range that we use it in majority of cases, you can say that, right? Like my IP is also there as per private IP in this range, right? Now before I explain you public and private IP address translation, let me show you practical example of my computer, right? So let me take you to my screen, and if you observe here, you see I have written IP config command. So when I written write IP config command, what will happen? I'll be getting my IPv4 address. You see, this is my IPv4 address. This is my private IP. I have told you this range, right? And usually majority of people are using this range only, where this is my IPv4 IP. This is my private IP. Now, how can I say this is my private IP? The reason is, if you observe here on Google, if I write what is my IP address, then this is my public IP address, right? This is my public IP address. So I'm communicating via this public IP address. And my private IP that I have shown by IP config command, right? Now, if you observe how communication happens, then if you observe this Wireshark link, so in that you see here, this is my private IP. This is my router's IP. So I am communicating with my router only. Now my router is communicating with the world. I am communicating with my router only, but my router is communicating with the world. Right, so that translation is done by router. So now I'll have to show you how that translation happens. So you see how it happens. For example, this is my computer. So with the use of DHCP protocol, so there will be DHCP server. There will be DHCP server on router. It will assign private IP to all the computer. Let us say this is my computer. I'm having my private IP, and see, I'm communicating with router only. Now router will be having over here public IP, right? Router will be having public IP. So what router does is, router will convert all the frames from private to public and public to private for internet communication. So in this LAN, all the computers will be having private IP. Likewise, there can be millions of LANs. So all the millions of LANs can reuse those private IP. All the millions of LANs, those can reuse these private IPs, right? So here, what I want to convey is, see, there are only 2 to the power 32 number of IP addresses. And probably if I talk about how many devices that is having internet right now in this world, so that is around 30 billion. See, 2 to the power 32 means 4 billion. And more than 30 billion devices are accessing internet. And they are accessing internet with IPv4, which I have told you right now. So with IPv4, if you have 4 billion IPs, then is it possible that you can assign single IP to all the devices? No. So here there is a concept of public and private. And based on that, everyone is communicating in entire globe right now, right? And that is happening because of public to private and private to public address translation, which happens at router. And this is referred as network address translation. So what I'll do is, in my next video, I'll explain you how exactly network address translation happens and how many types of network address translation that is available in this globe. If still anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.